lot of people see a yellow light as something that they need to hurry up so that they have time to cross it. In other words, when seeing a yellow light, they ask themselves the question, do I have time to pass? And a lot of times, they floor the accelerator to do so. The question you should be asking yourself instead when coming to a yellow light is, do I have time to stop? A yellow light, by law, requires you to stop if you can do so safely. That means that if you're not so close to the intersection that you would need to brake too suddenly, so that it could be dangerous to get hit from behind, you need to stop. If you're too close, you pass. And obviously, if you're already in the intersection when the light becomes yellow, you go. That's also true if you're already in the intersection while waiting to turn left. You need to finish your turn since you're already in the intersection. So if you want to turn left and there's already somebody in front in the intersection, wait behind the stop line until they've freed the intersection. Especially in cases like this one, where the vehicle in front is tall, so it prevents you from seeing what's in front. Wait until it frees the intersection before entering it. If you're going straight and there's no room for you to advance on the other side of the intersection, same thing, stay behind the stop line so that you won't block the intersection if the light turns yellow. Now, when I say you need to stop if you can do it safely, it depends mainly on two things. At what distance you are from the intersection and at what speed you're going. If I'm at this distance, but I'm going at 50 kilometers per hour, I pass. I'm too close to stop safely. If I'm at this distance going at 50, then I have time to stop. If I'm at this distance, but I'm moving as slowly as 5 kilometers per hour, let's say, because the traffic is heavy, I have plenty of time to stop safely. Basically, if you're driving at normal city speeds like 50 kilometers per hour, let's say, and you're in the intersection when the light turns red, usually that means that you had time to stop it. So you'll need to use your judgment for this kind of situation. It's very hard to say a definitive distance at which you should stop because your speed will vary a lot. At 5 kilometers per hour, this distance should be enough. At 30, it might be this distance. At 50, it might be this distance, and so on. And when the light turns yellow, you don't have time to check your speedometer and determine your distance. It's something that you'll do by feel once you get used to it. Unfortunately, students tend to have a hard time with this one because they don't have the same reflexes as an experienced driver. And those few extra seconds they hesitate are the seconds that make all the difference, since a yellow light usually only lasts more or less 3 to 5 seconds. A few things that may help you determine if the light is about to turn yellow are those countdowns for pedestrians. Often the light turns yellow when the countdown reaches zero. Not always, but often. But no matter if it does or not, if you see that it's already at zero, it's still a good indication that it'll turn yellow soon. In this case, it took 4 seconds. Another indicator is flashing green lights. A flashing green light here means priority to turn left, and it's either at the beginning of the cycle, meaning right after the red light, or at the end of the cycle, after the green normal steady light. And it usually lasts only a few seconds. So that means that when you see a green flashing light after the normal one, the light will soon turn yellow. And another indicator is if the light has been green for a while. So if you see a green light from far and it's been green for a while you were approaching it, keep in mind that it could turn yellow by the time you reach it. Now, something that happens a lot when people get a fine for not having stopped at a yellow light is that they go challenge the fine in court, with the argument being, I was already on the other side of the intersection when the light became red. That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where you were when the light turned red. This is not a race where you win when you've passed the line. If you had enough time to stop safely at the yellow and you didn't, you can get a fine. Because that's what that particular law states. If you have enough time to stop at the yellow safely, you must do so. And something that causes a lot of confusion in this case is that when this happens, most of the time people will tell you they had a fine for running a red light. Running a red light is when the light is already red and you run through it like this. Although this one here can also be considered running a red light since it was already red before the vehicle entered the intersection. This particular infraction is not stopping at a yellow light when you could have done so safely. Now, I'm not saying that you shouldn't challenge a fine whenever you have a valid reason to do so, but this argument alone of already being on the other side of the intersection when the light becomes red is not a valid reason. Flashing yellow lights mean there's something here that you should be careful about. At flashing yellow lights, you don't need to stop unless there's a reason to do so. They could be in places like pedestrian crossings, reserved lanes, like here where the flashing lights and the panel warn you that this lane will be reserved for buses and taxis in 50 meters. Obstacles, like here, to make things like medians more visible in certain situations, like at night, for example. School buses also have them, and it's the same principle as with regular traffic lights. They'll flash for a few seconds before turning red, so if you see them, you have to stop if you have enough time to do so safely. Basically, yellow is the color used for warning on road signs, since it's one of the most visible colors, especially in lower visibility situations, like at night or in bad weather. And something else that you need to be aware of at night is that yellow lights sometimes tend to be camouflaged by the surrounding street lights, which are usually of a yellowish tint, and also store signs, especially on commercial streets. In the next video, merging onto the highway. So stay tuned and see you soon.